Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Amen. Our Lady, health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
San Roque.
Pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
Give light to my eyes, lest I fall asleep in death, lest my enemies say, I have overcome him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we come into this Eucharistic celebration, let us ask the Lord that all our good works might be geared towards setting everything right again. And so to prepare ourselves for this celebration, let us first acknowledge our sins and humbly ask the Lord for His pardon and strength. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy.
And grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Guard your church, we pray, O Lord, in your unceasing mercy. And since without you, mortal humanity is sure to fall, may we be kept by your constant helps from all harm and directed to all that brings salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Hear the word of the Lord, princes of Sodom. Listen to the instruction of our God, people of Gomorrah. Wash yourselves clean. Put away your misdeeds from before my eyes. Cease doing evil. Learn to do good. Make justice your aim. Redress the wrong. Hear the orphan's plea. Defend the widow. Come now, let us set things right, says the Lord. Though your sins be like scarlet, they may become white as snow. Though they be crimson red, they may become white as wool. If you are willing and obey, you shall eat the good things of the land. But if you refuse and resist, the sword shall consume you, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Not for your sacrifices do I rebuke you, for your burnt offerings are before me always. I take from your house no bullock, no goats out of your fold.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
Why do you recite my statutes and profess my covenant with your mouth? Though you hate discipline and cast my words behind you,
to the upright, I will show the saving power of God.
When you do these things, shall I be deaf to it? Or do you think that I am like yourself? I will correct you by drawing them up before your eyes. He that offers praise as a sacrifice glorifies me. And to him that goes the right way, I will show the salvation of God.
To the upright, I will show the saving power of God. Please stand.
Sinabi ng buong mahal, kasamaan ay layuan, kasalan ay pagsisihan. Kayo ay magbagong buhay, magbalik loob na tunay.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus spoke to the crowds and to his disciples, saying, "The scribes and the Pharisees have taken their seat on the chair of Moses. Therefore, do and observe all things whatsoever they tell you, but do not follow their example. For they preach, but they do not practice. They tie up heavy burdens hard to carry, and lay them on people's shoulders, but they will not lift a finger to move them. All their works are performed to be seen. They widen their phylacteries and lengthen their tassels. They love places of honor at banquets, seats of honor in synagogues, greetings in marketplaces, and the salutation, Rabbi. As for you, do not be called Rabbi. You have but one teacher, and you are all brothers. Call no one on earth your father. You have but one Father in heaven. Do not be called Master. You have but one Master, the Christ. The greatest among you must be your servant. Whoever exalts himself will be humbled, but whoever humbles himself will be exalted. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
This Lenten season, we are encouraged to continue doing good works. Panahon ng Kwaresma, tayo po ay pinapaalalahanan na patuloy na gumawa ng kabutihan. But Jesus today reminds us of our motivation in doing good. Why are we doing all these good works, these charitable works? What is my motivation? And Jesus' example in our gospel today are the scribes and the Pharisees during his time. He said, do not follow their example because their works are performed to be seen. Gumagawa pala ng mabuti para makita lang ng tao. Their good works are performed so that they could be placed in honor. They use titles for themselves. They would want to sit at places of honor in banquets. That is their motivation. Doing good, performing good works is to be seen by people. But our readings today introduces to us one good motivation. In our first reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, the prophet reminds us that in doing good works, he said, let us set things right. Itama ang mga mali. That is one good motivation in doing good works, charitable works, this Lenten season. We are doing good, performing charity in the time of Lent, not to be seen, not to be honored, but to correct the wrong, to set things right. Gumagawa pala tayo ng kabutihan nang sa gayon ay maitama natin kung ano ang mali. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, this Lenten season, let this be our motivation. What are the wrong things that I need to set right? What are the wrong things that I need to correct? I hope that every charitable work, every good work that we will do this Lenten season may have this motivation to set things right. Sana po kapag mayroon tayong nagawa na pagkakamali, may nagawa tayo na hindi tama, sana ay matapang din tayo na aminin ang mali natin at itama kung ano yung maling nagawa natin. For example, I saw one friend who posted something on Facebook that is fake news. So someone alerted him that what he posted is fake. And so what he did was, he did not just erase the post, but he posted again, apologizing to people that what I posted was fake. It was my mistake. Sana lahat ganun, no? Kapag mayroong fake news na i-share, sana lahat marunong mag-sorry, sana lahat marunong itama. Kaya lang ang nangyayari ngayon, fake na nga yung sinabi niya, hindi na nga totoo, ang gusto pa niya, lusutan niya. Gagawa ng lahat ng excuses, no? Kung ano-ano, para makalusot lang, kahit na alam naman niyang mali yung kanyang sinabi. And you will see here the effects of sin. Pag kumalat na ang maling balita, masisira na yung iba-ibang mga tao. If we do not know how to set things right, then sin will have its continuous effects on others. That is why this Lenten season, this is a good reminder to all of us that our motivation in doing good is not just to be seen, not just to be honored by people, but we need to do good so that, according to the prophet Isaiah in our first reading, we must set things right. Sana po ngayong panahon na ito ng Kwaresma, ito po ang magawa natin. Maitama sana natin anuman ang maling nakikita natin, anuman ang maling nagawa natin. Sana we should have the courage to apologize, to ask for forgiveness, and most of all, most important is to correct it, to set everything right. As we continue this celebration of the Eucharist, as we ask the Lord for forgiveness this season of Lent, let us also ask the Lord for us to have the courage to say sorry and to set everything right. Amen.
Please stand.
Let us heed the admonition of our Lord, who taught us to do his work humbly and without ostentation. For every petition, let us say, Lord, lead us in the way of your Spirit.
Lord, lead us in the way of your Spirit.
The church leaders may be totally dedicated to their noble calling to preach the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, lead us in the way of your Spirit.
That parents and teachers may accompany their teachings with witnessing and good examples. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, lead us in the way of your Spirit.
That we may always seek to do what is right, and may God's word be a living power influencing our actions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, lead us in the way of your Spirit.
That we may look with love and compassion upon the sick, the old, and the lonely. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, lead us in the way of your Spirit.
That the dead may find rest and new life in the kingdom of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, lead us in the way of your Spirit.
Heavenly Father, deepen our faith so that we may grow in your love and always serve you with generous and sincere heart. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased to work your sanctification within us by means of these mysteries, O Lord, and by it may we be cleansed of earthly faults and led to the gifts of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you have given your children a sacred time for the renewing and purifying of their hearts, that freed from disordered affections, they may so deal with the things of this passing world as to hold rather to the things that eternally endure. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Broderick, our administrator, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Brothers and sisters, the body of Christ.
Amen.
Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I will bless him, his praise will be my mouth. My soul makes it boast in the Lord. The humble afflicted will be glad and join with me to magnify the Lord. Let us exalt his name together forever. I sought the Lord, he heard me and delivered me from my fears. Let us exalt his name together forever. Oh, sing his praises, magnify the Lord.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May the refreshment of this sacred table, O Lord, we pray, bring us an increase in devoutness of life and the constant help of your work of conciliation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We would like to thank all those who have joined us here physically in this celebration of the Mass. And we also want to thank the thousands who are watching us on online streaming of our Masses. We thank you for your continued support for our online ministry. Those who have sent their donations and help for the Manila Cathedral, we thank you for all of these. And we ask you also for continued prayers for all of us, especially in this ministry in our time of pandemic. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Graciously hear the cries of your faithful, O Lord, and relieve the weariness of their souls, that having received your forgiveness, they may ever rejoice in your blessing. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Until the end, to to your mission, Lord. We give our